I said figure D doesn't belong because the length, like the length of the number isn't a whole number. It's just 0.5.
I put figure A doesn't belong because it's the only equation that equals 32 and all the other ones equal 36.
Okay. Oh, multiply them. Okay. What'd you get?
C. So whenever I'm planning a lesson, I keep in mind, you know, the four principles of effective learning, and how, you know, how students best learn. So one of the things I think about is, you know, what do they already know, or what knowledge do they already have that I can build from the topic? So is it something we learned in a previous unit? Is it something we learned the day before? Or is it something they learned in an earlier grade? And I want them thinking about that you know, right before we go into the lesson.
And what about, the hard one. I'll take a volunteer for that one. Why is A, why doesn't A belong? Miguel.
I put it doesn't belong because it's the only one that equals to 32.
Okay, say that one more time.
It's the only one that equals to 32.
Okay, what's equal to 32?
When I multiply it.
When you multiply, do you remember what that's called?
Area.
Area, okay, it's the only one with the area of 32, okay? 8 times 4 is 32. All the other ones, the area is what? 36. Okay. That knowledge about area is going to be important for what we do today. Okay. So keep that in mind. How to find the area of a rectangle. All right. Because we're going to build on that for our learning today. All right. So let's do like a little ink pair share. Go ahead and get a dry erase marker at your table. I'm going to show you some stuff that we've been learning recently.
So after the starter, I had them do another activity, and this time it was just a free write. I just put up different equations or representations, and I just wanted them to just write down whatever came to mind. And the reason why I did that is because I want them to also see that what we're learning is also building from what we learned prior. We learned about different representations of quadratics, and this is now just another extension of that lesson. So I also wanted them thinking about that information and just having that information just downloaded into the short-term memory so I can build from it.
Okay. How is this connected to this, right? Like, where here do you see these same features? So I'll give you, think about that for a minute, and then I'll allow you to talk at your table. Okay, go ahead, have a quick conversation at your table, and then I'll call on someone. Where do you see those features?
Well, they obviously equal the same thing,
yeah,
but
yeah.
The first one is factored, I guess, and the second one is standard. Basically, they're like separating it.
So like on the shape, the whole shape is like equal?
Yeah, the whole shape, they're connected, but there's a line in between separating them, so it could be two different shapes.
Another effective principle of learning is the whole idea that learning is social, it's interpersonal. So after we engage our preconceptions, then I want the students to start kind of moving towards the new learning. And the way that we do that is to engage with new ideas and new concepts is I want them talking to each other, having those social interactions, kind of seeing if their ideas make sense to their classmates. Their classmates might challenge that idea, and then they might have to formulate it again, or they might extend it. So, but that's a very, very important part of the learning process.
All right, for three.
For this, you wouldn't add the x's, right? Because there's an exponent.
No, because there's an exponent. For three, it's basically x to the power of 2 plus 2x, right?
Plus 2x.
Because x is on this side.
So right. 2 times
so
x.
Two times x is.
Good.
X to the power of 2 plus 2x. Is there a fourth one? Okay.
And then another principle that researchers have found is just this whole idea of being able to apply what they've learned in routine as well as novel situations. So it turns out that the way that learning is actually organized is very important. So the knowledge needs to be kind of consolidated and organized at some point in the lesson. And it just makes it easier for students to be able to retrieve and apply that information.
Okay, so we're gonna pull everything we've learned so far. We're gonna try to just kind of organize it all, okay? So Olin's gonna hand you some notes. Once you get some notes, just based on what you know, try to see if you can fill in the blanks on that first example. Okay?
I want them to be engaged in the note-making process. I don't want it to just be a mindless thing that they do. So part of their notes is actually they have to make their own example based on what they learned, or they have to complete an example. So there's some scaffolds there built in for them, or they have to explain the steps. But the whole idea is to kind of get them thinking a little bit more as they're making notes, and a little bit more engaged in the note making process, instead of just having it be something they just copy down mindlessly from the board.
Okay, where's the 9X coming from? Combining like terms. Do you realize what we just did? We just did what? Went from? Two? You didn't even know you were doing that, did you? You just did it, right? Okay, so once you're done with your examples, go ahead and fill in your self-assessment here, okay? That was our learning goal. Put an X where you feel like you are. Do you feel like you're there, you're not yet there, or you're getting there, okay? If it's still a bit confusing. And then once you're done with that, fill out your 3-2-1 exit ticket. Three things you learned today, two things you found interesting, and a question you still have. And then you're gonna do your temperature check. Drop it off in one of the three trays on your way out, according to your confidence.
Another important principle of effective learning is this whole idea of metacognition. I mean, the students get feedback from me, but I also want them monitoring their own learning, seeing where they are, how they feel, what they've learned, and where they need to go next. So, and a couple of ways I did that in a lesson is, one, I just have them assess themselves. Do you feel like you accomplished the learning goal for today? So they interact with that learning goal again, see where they are. And then as they work out their example, again, to get to assess themselves again at the end of the lesson. And in this lesson, we did a 3-2-1 exit ticket, which is three things I learned, two things I thought were interesting, and one question I still have. And then if there are any questions, any misconceptions they have, you know, they get to put those down. And then I have a temperature check at the door. They can put it in a green bin and, you know, and say, I got it. They can put it in a yellow bin, which means they kind of get it, but they need a little bit more support. Or the red bin, which means, you know, they don't get it yet, but they're still working towards those learning goals. So those are some of the metacognitive strategies that were embedded into that lesson. I think it's very important to, as much as we can, try to have those elements in every lesson, because overall it creates a more engaged learner in the classroom.